Hi, Mr. Haddad. Good afternoon. I have a question for you. There's a saying that freedom is the reason for chaos in the society. And I would like to know your point of view on that thing. I want to know if you agree to me or not.
Alright. Well, I think, well, to answer your question directly, I'll say that freedom is not the reason for the chaos, but the misunderstanding or the misconception behind the concept of freedom is the reason for the chaos in the society. You see, freedom is not it's not doing anything you want to do, alright? I hope you get that. And chaos, on the contrary, it's a state of complete disorder or confusion. I mean, even in physics, we see chaos as a property of a complex system whose behavior is so unpredictable as to appear random over time. So you're free to think what you want to think, but you're not free to act in the way you want to act. For instance, if like both of us are here, I could decide to carry a knife. I think of it that, okay, carry a knife and kill her. But on the reverse, I cannot carry a knife and kill you because I am free to think, but I'm not allowed to think. It means that my freedom to think does not translate to my freedom to act, because my freedom to act is limited or is restrained by some laws and by some principle that nature had placed in us. All right, but before I push this argument stronger, I want you to agree with some things with me. So let's think of evolution and creation. I think that's the best concept I could pick for this discussion. Well, evolution is a scientific theory that seeks to explain the origin of man, whereas creation is a spiritual, I think, metaphysical or religion theory that tries to explain the origin of man. Well, while we consider evolution as a gradual change in species over time, creation is more of, well, I created you. So evolution, for me, seems to tell me that how man is created, whereas religion or creation is telling me that God created man, and that is it. Well, whether we agree or not, we will come to that. Take for instance, when one day your father and your mother, your father and your mother had sexual intercourse, and the sperm that was formed in your father's testicle and maybe developed in his seminiferous tubule and stored in his epididymis suddenly traveled through the vas deferens, went through the seminal vesicle, went through the corpus gland, the prostate gland, and left your father's urethra completely. Your father's genitalia moving to your mother's genitalia, and it travels through to the oviduct where it met and excels and fertilizes it. And the formation called the zygote comes into the endometrium wall and is implanted, and it begins to divide, it begins to enlarge, and then organs begins to differentiate. So you have the different organs responsible for the different functions in the body. One thing I know science is able to explain, the process from the sperm to the zygote, to the embryo, to the fetus. But what science has failed to tell me is how the mind, the spirit, and the soul came into being. When it gets to that level, beyond that level, I think spiritual or metaphysical is needed to explain that. So it's no argument that, well, God created man, or an intelligent designer designed man. However, the process of man living and competing and adapting to his environment change the current man we are having today from the ancient man we had years back. And that seems to me like sound argument. So there is a meeting point between evolution and creation, but let's pause it there. If you think of it greatly and say, okay, how was my mind formed? How was the sperm formed? Because I think science have tried to prototype humans and they failed quite a number of times. How was the sperm formed? How was my mind formed? How was my soul? How did I have a spirit that I have today? That will exactly or immediately tell you that there is an intelligent designer somewhere that is designing the world we live in. And that intelligent designer has kept things in hierarchical order. Now, if we distort that hierarchy, we distort that order, there is bound to be a chaos. Take for instance, you in your family, for instance, it's the structure is a man, your father to your mother and then to you. If that hierarchy is distorted so that you come intermediate between your father and mother, there is a problem. It means that there is going to be trouble in that family, because your father cannot communicate to you to go and communicate to your mother. Neither can your mother speak to you to go and talk to your father. And that would be chaos. And so, there are a lot of models. Even at that, there is this other model that the radical feminists are actually proposing today, that the man and the woman are in the same level and the child is below. I mean, man is not equal to woman by all ramifications. You can say that, okay, equality of opportunity, equality of outcomes is something any human being should desire. But when you begin to say man and woman are equal, they are not equal, because, I mean, these things are biologically, with biological reality. For instance, a woman is an XX chromosome, a man is an XY chromosome. These genetic differences make a man to behave in a certain way, a woman to behave in a certain way. It's psychologically again proven that women are most psychologically strong to handle emotional issues than men, way beyond. Women have a better tolerance ratio than men. Women can endure things than men. So you cannot argue certain things. There are things that make a man, and there are things that make a woman a woman. But you see, the freedom to think and the freedom to want to act based on what you think is what is actually plunging the world into chaos. Because, I mean, in our previous video, we had spoken before that the ontological reality of being is that we are limited, and limitation simply is proclivity towards suffering. I mean, so if you understand your limitation so well, you will already know that, okay, this limitation places on me certain confines in which I must operate. So beyond those confines, if I want to operate there, I'll begin to be an object of confusion. I'll plunge the world into confusion. Let's look at this, for instance. I am a man, and by all standard, I'm a man. But someday, if I begin to love to be a woman, I have the freedom to think it. But when I begin to act it, it becomes a problem. So you discover that, okay, I am created a man, I'm limited to be a man, and suddenly my freedom to think translates me into wanting to become the Barbarisky, the James Brown over time. That becomes a problem, that becomes a confusion. So you are free to think, but we are not free to act the way we want to act, because it's the freedom to think and acting based on your freedom that led to the problems we are having in the society today. It has led to the problem of the Barbarisky of our time, the James Brown of our time. It has led to the problem of everyone wanting to be rich, and it has led to the problem of marriage not becoming marriage being shattered here and there. But there's something I have to say, and I have to say it very seriously. You are free to think, but if your freedom of thinking produces thoughts, and you allow your thoughts to cage you in a prison such that the only thing you want to express is the beatings of your thought, the truth is that you have again imprisoned you in yourself. And I mean, that's the truth. Because if you understand that as a human being, we are free to think, but we are not free to act in a way we are thinking, then the world will not be heading to chaos. But once you begin to think that, well, I'm free to think anything I want to do, and I'm free to act in any way I want to act, then, I mean, that is what is leading the world to chaos. Simply put, you're free to think. Freedom of thoughts is a desirable attribute, but freedom to act on everything you think is not a desirable attribute. Let me say this. No matter how free you are, your freedom has some limitation. Operate within the confines of the limitation of your freedom. Go beyond that confine, you're plunging the world into chaos. I hope that helps you.